or the Nexa. Okay, so what, how come this car is of Baleno, car is of Nexa, okay, that is Maruti Suzuki, but still car, dekho carwale.com upar pehle kaise aa jate? It is because that website or that link are viewed by most of the customers. So that is why they get a higher rating and higher ranking in the search engine marketing. Okay, so the third component of internet marketing is email marketing. I believe we all are aware about email marketing. Email marketing is what? Nothing but promoting, advertising or sharing information of goods, services or ideas through emails. Okay. Now next is banner advertising. Banner advertising is nothing but it is a fee generating advertising. There are special agencies who concentrate on this banner advertising. Now what is banner advertising? We see all the banners on banners are put up on the bus stop or the highways and all that. That is a physical format of banners. Now when I talk about internet internet marketing banners, they are nothing but a banner which has been made and mailed or you know is been through sent through using through use of internet, or it is also being posted on company's website for a fee. So you understood what is banner advertising. Now we'll go further for online press release. Online press release means what? Company has encountered anything noteworthy about their company. मतलब कंपनी के रिलेटेड कुछ अच्छा न्यूज़ आ गया, उनकी वेबसाइट पे कुछ अच्छा यू नो प्रोग्रेस हो गया, या उनका प्रोडक्ट हिट हो गया मार्केट में, या दे हैव इंक्रीज देयर कस्टमर बेस. एनी सच बिग न्यू नोटवर्दी न्यूज़ आर बीन रिलीज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ प्रेस फॉर अदर पीपल. कंपनी रिलीजेस दिस इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड इट इज डिवाइडेड और डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड अमंग वेरियस अदर इंटरनेट फॉर्मैट्स. ओके, इंटरनेट वेबसाइट्स. Next is blog marketing. What do you mean by blog marketing? Blog marketing is nothing but where you express your feelings or opinions or feedback, okay, in either of the format. Either you have your own blog, that is you have your own space where you can put your comments, or else you can continue where you know the information is given or the product is being shown, and downside you can continue your opinions or feedback. You might have seen whenever you see this YouTube video or any product on Google, we find the various reviews and the feedbacks of the different kind of customer. That is nothing but that is a blog. Okay, either you write your own blog, you have your own blog, you have your own page, or else you can continue your expressing your opinions or feelings or anything on that particular URL. Next is article marketing. Article marketing is publicizing your article, like related to company, related to customer, related to any new product that is getting launched. And again, it is same like online press release. If there is something new which is coming up, I just circulate that among other internet website users. Okay, and I try to you know spread it as much as I can in the masses. That is nothing but article marketing. A particular article written on a particular product. Okay, like a company do not focus on one product, they have varieties of product. Usme se koi ek particular product hit ho jata hai market mein, or there are best reviews which are coming up, or else so these are kind of articles, okay, which company wants that every person should come to know about it, about their success, about their achievements. Okay, so these articles are being made and framed and even is circulated to other you can say portals. Last is social media marketing. Social media marketing is again nothing but using all different forms of networking websites, like you can say Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn. Okay, these are nothing but different media formats, social media which have been used to promote particular product, promote particular company. So these are the components which are being used in internet marketing. Switching to the other part of digital or other form of digital marketing is social media marketing. Now what do you mean by social media marketing? It is approaching target customer through social media sites such as Facebook, Twitter, etc. It is one of the components. Social media marketing is one of the component of internet marketing, and it is the different form of digital marketing. If you see digital marketing mein sab kuch interrelated hai. Jaise abhi humne ek point dekha, jo component internet marketing ka hai, it itself is one form of marketing again in itself. Okay, so it is nothing but I am trying to approach my target customer through use of various social medias. Now what are the social media? Again, it is rightly said that the social media sites like Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, etc. Now, what are the different, I'll say, social media platforms which have been used to market a particular product? First is social networking sites, that is through which we can get higher connectivity. Hum log aajkal bolte hain hamare pics agar hum upload karte Facebook pe, we see how many likes we have got. Now who can view your picture? First thing, either you have made it public, anybody can see, or else it is your friends or family, the number of people who are in your friend list. We go on, we feel proud that haan mere friend list mein 500 friends hai, mere isme 700 friends hai. These are nothing but all in connection with you through your social networking sites. Okay, you have built up a network of 500 friends. Now any such ad, you know, if you want to promote any of a product, if you want to share any information, okay, you just put it on your page and it is being circulated to 500 700, the number of people that are in your friend list. And if it is not you know, you have not activated friend list only, then it goes to the masses. So first platform is nothing but social networking site, that is Facebook is used for sharing, you know, for making friends, and sharing pictures, and you're sharing your personal life basically. Second, personal experience as well. Twitter again for the same. LinkedIn is basically for professional relationship, that is for jobs or any of what you can say, you are trying for some particular post, or where you have worked for, your work experience, everything is being shared on LinkedIn. That is your professional website. Next is blogs. As I have said over here, in internet marketing, blog marketing, yes, in somewhat similar format is the blog. Now blogs are of two types. It is personal blog and business blog. Then from the name itself you can make it out. Personal means where I am putting my own personal views, my own personal what you can say, opinions. Okay, I've been put in personal blogs. I write all my, I express my feeling, I say my opinion, whatever achievements I want to say, satisfaction of a, through a particular product or services, all that experiences I share in my personal blog. Whereas exactly opposite is my business blog, where I try to share about my the business, the turnover that have taken place, the number of you can say the famous products that have been used, a new customer base, or a product which has been highly accepted by the people. I'll say that whenever car gets a car of any car or SUV or hatchback gets a car of the year award, okay, now that all kind of news and everything are being posted in the business blogs. Third is discussion board on forums. It is nothing but where actually it is a portal basically, okay, where the discussion takes place between the actual users and the company. Whatever they what you can say, the feedback, okay, or the what you can say, the problems that a customer have encountered, a board is formed, a forum has been formed, where the discussion of all these, or what basically customer expect from the customer is expecting from the company, or new products that they want, etc. All these details are being discussed, and the necessary actions are basically taken. Even the company who is coming up with a new product, before product is getting launched for the masses, a small test marketing drive is being taken place, where actually the existing customers are being given a chance to use the product. Again, that information is being somewhat given on this discussion board and forums. Next, photo sharing site. The name itself signifies, photo sharing means you are sharing your pictures. Now I agree, Facebook is the common networking site where people used to post their photographs. But other than Facebook, there are more sites, like for example Kodak Gallery or Flickr site, okay, where people actually go on posting their photographs, and the photos are being viewed by masses. Next is penetration sharing site. Now what do you mean by penetration sharing site? It is nothing but where the company uploads the PPT. Like for example, you just type social PPT on social networking site, or social networking, sorry, not social networking site, but social media marketing. Now when I just say, I just put it in the Google, I need information on social media marketing. First information you get either in the form of a Word document, or else you get in the form of a PDF, or else you get in the form of a PPT. That is nothing but when I talk about PPT or information getting, I need to get it in the form of PPT, it is nothing but penetration sharing site, where generally the PPTs are uploaded by the people. Next is Instagram. I don't think I need to explain what is Instagram. Instagram is an app which has been widely used by today's generation. For and actually what it does, it filters the videos, the audios, the pictures, and it has been shared, or you know, it has been followed by the number of people who are there in your contact list basically. Last is the YouTube. Again, it is a form of a marketing for masses. Like for example, you have missed out any serial, you have missed out on any of the live shows or food recipes or anything you want to see in any of your language, your own vernacular language, your own media form language. Every videos are available on YouTube. You name recipes, you get it, the recipes. You name beauty products, or you can see how the way of, you know, hairstyling nowadays. Hairstyling has been, you know, popular website, or I'll say popular video, which has been mostly viewed by the females on YouTube. So these are the different forms of social media platforms. I hope you have understood by now what is social media. Now we go further for viral marketing. What do you mean by viral marketing? Viral marketing is nothing but which focus on disseminating information rapidly to maximum population. Okay, then the meaning itself signifies what is viral marketing is: disseminate information rapidly by making it likely to be passed from person to person via electronic means. Like again, this is interrelated. Like for example, when I talk about YouTube, if any video I put it on YouTube, what happens? It gets viral quickly. Okay, if any information I put it on Facebook or Twitter, it again gets viral quickly. So it is somewhat again similar to my social media, but it's in the different heading name, that is viral marketing. Now there are three types of viral marketing. First is market mavens, where only interesting information is being passed on. Interesting information means what? Interest for you and me might be different, but over here it is related to the welfare, or it is related to the community, where people have mostly interests, a few interesting topic. Like for example, news related to education, news related to jobs, which affect majority people, or which is of common interest of many of the people. That information, interesting information, is being shared on market mavens. Second is your social hubs. What do you mean by social hubs? Where people with large number of connections, okay, social hub is nothing but where there are maximum number of people, or they have maximum connection, they use these to transmit information, to pass on any of the product that they want to sell, or any ideas that they want the others to know. That is nothing but social hubs. And the last is sales people. The name itself suggests. Sales people means what? The marketer person who is trying to pursue, who is trying to convert the potential customer into my actual customer. These are nothing but sales people. They send to the potential buyers the new product which has been launched. Like for example, you can see HDFC Bank, maximum SIPs or mutual fund, mutual fund or SIPs which are coming up. Like I believe you understand what is mutual fund and SIP. It is nothing but a small format of investment opportunities which are given to the customers, okay? The small amount of money which has been collected. Now, there are many people who are not aware of mutual fund or SIPs. So, what does HDFC does? HDFC does nothing but the salesperson in the bank, okay? He sends the mail of the upcoming facilities or upcoming SIPs to all the potential buyers, where he thinks that yes, some out of 1,000, at least 5 to 7 people or 10 people might turn back and get converted from potential into actual customer. That is nothing but again types of messengers which have been used in viral marketing. Now viral marketing works on 5 basic principles. Now what are that 5 basic principles? First is give away valuable products and services. Like for example, we see that viral marketing is used for many of the negative things. Like for example, spreading of MMS. Now if MMS is really good enough, then it is good. If it is educating, or you know, it is knowledge building, then it is good. But we do understand when I talk about MMS, what kind of MMS we assume. So that is a very wrong way, or you know, it is a disadvantage of using this viral marketing concept. So what is the basic principle of using these form of marketing? That give away the information which is valuable, okay, in terms of product and services. Do not use these kind of tool to actually, you know, to harm other people. Second is provide effortless transfers. Now, viral marketing focus on that there should not be a problem for a person to transfer information to majority or the masses. It should be very easy. For example, when I say there are people who are not able to use properly the mobile phone, there are people who cannot use this internet marketing to effectively. Why? Because of lack of education. So that is one more principle, that whosoever is using viral marketing, for him or her, it should be very much easy to use these form of marketing. It should be effortless basically. The third principle, scales very easily from small to large. The main motive of viral marketing is what? To reach the masses. As I say over here, pass from person to person via electronic means. So the third principle focus on what? I need not only focus on small category of people, but I need to go to a larger masses. The fourth, exploit common motivation and behaviors. Like the people, they target these customers, they target the customer who have a common motivation. As I said just now, over here, market mavens, interesting information. Like everybody will be interested in what is going on in the economy. Everybody is interested that the new schemes that a government comes up with. Everybody is interested in the job opportunities. What is happening in the education field? What is happening in the science field? What is happening with the builder lobby? Why? Because redevelopment projects are very much in focus nowadays. Yes. So basically the fourth principle says about viral marketing is it should exploit common motivation and behavior. The last one, utilizes existing communication network. It should use basically for every resources, what we say, there has to be optimum utilization of resources. Now when I say viral marketing, it should utilize existing communication network to the optimum level. Like for example, again, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, everything, okay? Now all that should be used, all the mode of communication network should be used for passing valuable information on products and services. It should be easy to transfer. Again, it should not only focus on small target of customer, but it should reach to the larger masses, and these larger masses should have common motives and behavior. I believe viral marketing is very much clear to you. Moving further, we'll go for telemarketing. Now, what do you understand by telemarketing? The name itself suggests tele means hello, hello, hi. So that is nothing but a marketing activity which is carried out on phone. Okay. Now, telemarketing is further divided into two parts. It has two types basically. One is inbound, one is outbound. Inbound means you are getting calls from the company. Okay, like for example, salespeople, what they do, they call you for selling loans, credit card, debit card, again packages, yes, holiday packages, or making you a member of any of the company or any of the event, etc. So that is inbound, where a customer receives a call. On contrary is the outbound, where the customer calls the company. Now customer calls the company in what, for what reason? One is either they are not satisfied with the customer, either there is a particular feedback that they want to give, either like for example, I buy a washing machine or I buy any electronic gadget like AquaGuard or anything, and I call for after sales services or I ask for the installation of the product. So in all these situations, customer calls the company, that is nothing but a outbound. Okay, now further, there are obviously all marketing format has few advantages and disadvantages. Now we will see about advantages of telemarketing. What are the advantages of telemarketing? First of all, it reduces cost. Calling people, now we all agree that per call, now it has gone on seconds. When you talk about your mobile calling, what has happened? It is no more than 1 rupee for 1 minute. Okay, it has reduced to seconds. Now these are about mobile phone. Imagine about the landlines. I remember MTNL scheme, 250 incoming is free and outgoing is some limited, 100 minutes are free. Now this is at an individual level. Imagine when I am a big company, I get so many discounts, or I get my cost as compared to my customer comes down drastically. Second is two-way communication. Telephone, all these mediums, okay, at times becomes one-way communication. Company over here, if you see that banner advertising, email or search engine, what happens in all this? It is one-way communication. Company is trying to give you the information about whatever they want to give. Okay, but when I talk about telemarketing, it is two-way communication, in inbound or outbound, any type you take, it is two-way communication. The person who is there on the other side of the phone, either he is giving you the information, either he is taking information from you. Third is 24/7 support. If you see the BPO or the call centers of any company, okay, they are operating round the clock, that is 24 hours a day and 7 days a week. So in short, it is 365 days working also. Yes, like for example, you see your SIM card companies, okay, you call them at night 2 o'clock also, they are ready to answer you. And if you talk about Indian company, you see the example of Just Dial. You call anytime to them and they are ready to give you information. Third is flexibility. Flexibility in what format? Whatever information you want to give, you can take that information, or whatever feedback you want to give, you can give that feedback. So this marketing format is very much flexible. Like again, one more example for flexibility. If you say that you are right now busy, if you right now you get a call, you are in middle of something, you are working or something, okay, you are in classes. So at that time you say you call me after half an hour. So it is very much flexible, you see. They will again record your request or anything, and they will again give you a call back after half an hour. In many of the forms, when you fill banking form or insurance form, they ask you the convenient time of calling. So you say no calls between 12 to 5. So they are definitely, there is a record which has been kept that this customer is not supposed to be called between 12 to 5. So this is not, the telemarketing is very much flexible concept. Next is better customer relationship. When you try to talk with somebody, okay, over here there is no physical interaction, okay, no physical, I'll say no communication by words in through any of the company people. But when I talk about telemarketing, there is a company representative whom you are talking with. So in that case, it becomes very easy, as human touch is present in telemarketing. A human is there to address your problem. A human is there to guide you about a product or in service that you need. So in that case, always a customer relation is better, not only better, it is at the bestest level. Sixth point is quick result. Telemarketing delivers quick result. If customers say no, it is immediately understood that customer is not interested, when I'm talking about inbound. If the customer is interested, then again I get quick results that yes, customer is in for the product, customer is out for the product. There is no way where 50-50 chances that the customer might come, might not come. There is no such situation. Next is measurable. It is easy to measure that in a day I have made 1,000 calls, out of 1,000 customer I have been able to convert so many potential customer into actual customer. So basically over here it is measurable. I am calling in a day 1,000 customer. Whereas in other formats of marketing, how many customer has viewed my ad is a big question till date. Other than YouTube, where YouTube you see, you have it goes on recording the number of viewers that are that actually go through your videos. But when I talk about Facebook advertisement or any other form of advertisement, you actually, company doesn't come to know how many customer has viewed their ads. Next, increase efficiency. It is very much efficient format. Why? Because there is a human touch in that, and a customer also feels safe when they interact with the human. Gathering information. In telemarketing, they not only give away information, they try to gather the information from the customer as well regarding their likes, dislikes, preferences, their experiences about using after using the product or the services. Next, increase customer base. Now I'll say, what is the population of India? It is 120 crores. So 120 crore potential buyers. Okay, slowly, steadily, what happens? Today I call 1,000 people, tomorrow again I'll call 1,000 people. That is how I'm taking information and my customer base is going on increasing. Last is, it improves customer services. Why? Because you regularly take their feedback, you talk to them, they are ready to give you their opinion. So it ultimately improves customer services. However, there are 11 advantages. There are few disadvantages. Obviously, coin has two sides. So ultimately, telemarketing also has a two side. Although there are so many advantages, but there are few disadvantages. Now, what are the disadvantages? First is no visual contacts, which is present in personal selling. What happens when I talk about personal selling? You are able to talk to a person who is in front of you. You can make somebody accountable. But when somebody is over the phone, there is no visual contact between you and that company representative. So that is the biggest disadvantage. How can you trust anybody who is there on the other side of the phone? Second is expensive. At time, it is considered to be expensive. Why? Because 1,000 customer you are calling, or 1,000 turns out to be to be not turning from actual to potential to actual. What happened? That is a big loss. Again, and it is expensive when it comes to, if I compare email and telemarketing, telemarketing becomes expensive. Why? Because email or internet marketing is free of cost. Third, irritation. Customer do get irritated by the regular calls. And that's what happened. The moment you telemarketing person called, the customer just hung up on them. So it basically, that is again a disadvantage. Next, outsourcing. Many of the companies have outsourced their call centers. Now telemarketing is taken care through call centers. Now many companies have given away their or outsourced their call centers. Now a customer feel insecure. Why? Because they have dealt with a particular company for the product, and now some other company is calling them for the for selling or for taking a feedback or the reviews, and all the information are revealed to the third company. So that is again most disadvantageous position when I talk about outsourcing of this telemarketing concept. So that was for outsourcing. Now we go for others. Now what do I mean by others? Now you just think, तुम किसी से फोन पे बात करते हो, कितने टाइम तक वो तुमको याद रहता है? इट इज फ्यू मिनट्स, फ्यू आवर्स, फ्यू डेज. देन व्हाट हैपेंस? यू फॉरगेट द कॉन्वर्सेशन विच इज टेकिंग प्लेस ऑन फोन. वेयर एज व्हेन यू टॉक इन टू अ पर्सन इन यू नो इन पर्सन, यू रिमेंबर दैट कॉन्वर्सेशन वेरी नाइसली. सो दैट इज वन ऑफ द मेजर डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ टेलीमार्केटिंग, दैट पीपल टेंड टू फॉरगेट, बिकॉज पीपल हैव अ शॉर्ट मेमोरी, दे टेंड टू फॉरगेट द टेलीफोनिक कॉन्वर्सेशन. So these are the advantages and 11 advantages and 5 disadvantages of telemarketing. I believe it is clear in your head now. Now we go further to mobile marketing. What you understand by the word mobile? It is not a rocket science when we talk about mobile. Every individual has a mobile, and some maharat, koi maharati ke pas do mobile phone. अगेन एक मोबाइल फोन में दो सिम कार्ड, तो दो मोबाइल फोन में चार सिम कार्ड. बहुत बिग पर्सनालिटीज होते हैं, उनका ये होता है. सो मोबाइल मार्केटिंग नथिंग बट मार्केटिंग ओवर अ मोबाइल फोन. नाउ देर आर 5 टाइप्स थ्रू विच मार्केटिंग टेक्स प्लेस ऑन अ मोबाइल. फर्स्ट इज SMS. द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ SMS इज शॉर्ट मैसेज सर्विसेज. दैट इज द मैसेजेस दैट यू गेट इन योर इनबॉक्स. Various companies, like you can talk about any beauty company, you can talk about your own network provider, like a SIM card provider, they come up with various offers. All that are intimated to you in the form of a SMS. Second is MMS. MMS is nothing but multimedia services in the form of a video clipping. Okay, that you get in MMS is being circulated through mobiles as well. Next is app. Every phone are now from basic, they have been upgraded to Android version, and we try to install various apps. Now on that apps also we get various advertisement. Like for example, recently now we have started getting marketing messages about any company through WhatsApp as well. Okay, so that is nothing but marketing using various apps. Even company has developed their own app. For example, if I say there is one app which I recently saw, that is Chalo College. Chalo College is a app which has been built by student itself, BSc IT student. Okay, now they have developed this ad giving information about the colleges, giving information about the cutoff of the colleges. Okay, first list, second list, you name any detail about colleges. Okay, and you get all that information on that app, and that app again installation is free of cost. Okay, so various advertisement done on the app. Next is in game. If you remember movie Ravan, not Ravan, it's Raone, Ravan, the movie which was done by Shah Rukh Khan. Now smartly, he is one of the person who uses all the marketing format very smartly. Movie shayad usko pata tha itna hit na ho. Okay, movie was a flop, but what he did before the movie got launched, he came up with a game, Ravan game, where all the kids were attracted towards that game, 3D game. Okay, it was a 3D game. So that is one more format where I tried to promote my product in the way of game. Okay, and the last is Bluetooth mobile marketing. Now Bluetooth, this is one of the feature of a mobile. Okay, what is that? Bluetooth transfers we usually. Now in this Bluetooth transfer, I do not mean by that feature of Bluetooth. In Bluetooth marketing, mobile marketing, it is nothing but again the marketing activities goes viral. वायरल वेयर दैट इज वाई इट इज नोन एज ब्लूटूथ. ब्लूटूथ से हम इजिली किसी को भी हम डेटा दे सकते हैं, इजिली डेटा रिसीव कर सकते हैं. ओके नाउ द ओनली थिंग इज द पेयरिंग हैज टू बी देयर, बट इन दिस मोबाइल ब्लूटूथ मोबाइल मार्केटिंग पेयरिंग इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. इट इज जस्ट दैट द मार्केटिंग द फोन और द नंबर्स विच आर बीन गिवन द देर इज ईजी ट्रांसफर अमॉन्ग दैट पर्टिकुलर पेयरिंग डिवाइस. So these are the five types of mobile marketing. Again, as the advantages and disadvantages of telemarketing, mobile marketing also has certain advantages and disadvantages. Let's have a look at it. First, what are advantages? It has instant result. Why and how? We all know. अगर message अच्छा लगा हम contact करेंगे, message अच्छा नहीं लगा हम immediately delete करेंगे. Simple. App अगर कुछ अच्छा लगा we will download, we will play further. If we don't like it we uninstall the app. So it is very easy for a company to understand whether the customer has been actually converted into my actual customer or it is still a potential customer. Next, it is easy and cheap. It is easy and cheap as compared to telemarketing and other forms of marketing. Once you develop an app and you know you just circulate it, it is free of cost. Again for the customer, but again it goes for masses. And even when I talk about SMS or MMS, okay, obviously it is a bit costly. It is charged, okay, it is chargeable, but the target customer, okay, the huge target customer in front of them, it becomes very cheap. Next is personal interaction. Through mobile, what happens? I am able to concentrate on a particular person. It gives a personal touch feeling. That's why it is said that personal interaction is possible when I talk about when mobile marketing is used. Next, tracking user response. It is very easy when a person is using a mobile phone because if there are 120 crore population, so the number of mobile phones which are used are easily recorded. The number of services which a customer use is easy to record. So in that way, it is easy for a customer also and for a company also to track the response. Next is huge viral potential. As I said, like for example, when I use app, now Android phone, approximately 50,000 or 50 lakh Android phones are in circulation. So you can at least calculate that there is a huge potential of my product getting viral. Next is mass communication. Again, as lot of people, they target, the customer base is huge. It is a position where, you know, companies actually not aware about their target customer. They want to make their product available for masses. So this is the best way through which marketing can take place. That is mobile marketing. Last, micro blogging benefit. What do you mean by micro blogging? It is nothing but micro blogging, like Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn are no more reserved for computers. Now these things are also operated through mobile phones. So that is what it means by micro blogging benefit. मोबाइल हम खोलते तो क्या सिर्फ SMS या कॉल के लिए यूज़ करते? Gone are the days when people used to only use it for calling. Now people are doing mails, they are checking their Facebook status, they are checking their Twitter account, they are writing the blogs through mobile phone. So that is nothing but micro blogging benefit. Well, as far as advantages are concerned, there are few disadvantages as well. We'll see to the disadvantages. Platform too diverse. Too diverse means what? There are different customers which are exposed to mobile marketing. Now to record each and every person's likes, dislike, or to send that product, it becomes difficult because I am targeting mass people. Now there, out of mass population, there are chances that I do not have my potential customer or target customer is inclusive in that. So that's why platform become too diverse for the product, and there are which segment of the customer should I target? That becomes a big question. Next is privacy issue. As you might have noticed, the moment you try to download any app, they ask you for one question. There is 5-6 question block which is open, and then last is accept. If you do not accept, what happens? You are not able to download that. Now what details do they ask? Have you noticed that? Kabhi dhyan se dekha ki kya details wo log chahte? They ask for you for the access to your contact details, the access to your photographs, everything, and there is a tick mark on all of that. Once you accept that means they have an access to entire of your contact list. Now there are 200, 300, 500 contact number which are saved, which is easily going to that company, okay, whose app you are downloading. So there is a big privacy issue when it comes to mobile marketing. Third is navigation on mobile phone. The biggest problem again of navigation is that internet facility. Now mobile phone, to use all of this app or games and everything, you need Online network. Now possible is that everywhere network is not available. So that is one problem. Second is that because there is a limitation that mobile phone has a small screen as compared to your laptop or desktop or your PC. So what happened at that time also navigation becomes a problem. Scrolling. You might have seen, you just take an example of Flipkart or a Snapdeal or Amazon. There are huge variants of products available on their site, which is actually not possible to view all of them product when it comes to mobile phone. So that is again, that is also considered in navigation. And the last one, not user friendly. Not everybody knows how to operate Android phone. So for them, these customers who do not know how to use a smartphone or an Android phone are directly going out of being a potential customer. Although they have the potential of buying a product, but using how to use it on mobile phone may be a problem for them. So that's why one of the disadvantages is mobile marketing is not at all user friendly. So again, quickly if we see, now what we have done, digital marketing. Digital marketing has five formats, that is internet marketing, social media marketing, viral marketing, telemarketing and mobile marketing. Now as far as your exam point of view, if you can see, these all individual form can be asked in short note of 5 marks. Okay, so focus should be that first you need to know entire forms of digital marketing, and along with that a separate question can be asked in the form of a short note saying what is internet marketing, or explain explain telemarketing. Any of this one can also be asked. So my request is please do this thoroughly, because this is very important from your exam point of view. All right, you can take down the points. Thank you.